Hello, Agent. Our journey begins at the enchanted castle of Numberland, where knowledge is locked away behind closed doors. The castle's door is secured with the strength of 3 locks, needing 3 keys to be opened. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to solve this code and collect the first key. To do this, you will need to identify or represent 3 numbers using what you know about base 10 blocks. Can you use what you know about tens and ones to collect the first key to the castle? The first code awaits you. Do you accept this mission?
A mission to unlock Numberland's castle? We're in! To crack this code and earn the first key, we will need to identify or represent 3 numbers using what we know about base 10 blocks. We know that these are called 1 blocks and they are worth 1. And these are called 10 blocks and they are worth 10. I think we're ready for the first part of the code. How many tens do you see? Good! There are 4 tens. 4 tens makes a pretty big number. How can we count to quickly find out what number these tens represent? We can skip count by tens. Count with me. 10, 20, 30, 40. These 10 blocks represent 40. Now, if we look at the ones, we can count on from 40 to identify this number. 41, 42, 43. We cracked the first part of the code. Great job. Let's move on to the next challenge. How many tens do you see? Good! There are 3 tens. Now, how many ones do you count? There are 7 ones. 3 tens and 7 ones. If we put these 2 numbers side by side, it makes the number 37. Do you think that is our answer? Let's double check. We can skip count the 10 blocks, 10, 20, 30, and then we can count on with our 1 blocks, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, and 37. Wow! So if we count how many 10 and 1 blocks there are, we can identify the number. There's only 1 more part of the code to crack, and this one is a little different. Instead of identifying the number, it is our job to use base 10 blocks to represent the number 28. We need to draw a quick picture to show how many 10 and 1 blocks there are in this number. Let's get started. As usual, let's start with the tens. Looking at the number 28, which number do you think tells us how many tens there are? The first digit is the tens place, which means it tells us how many tens are in a number. There is a 2 in the tens place, which means there are 2 tens. I can draw 2 tens with 2 lines just like this. Awesome! Now, how do we figure out how many ones are in 28? This digit is in the ones place, which means there are 8 ones in 28. We can draw ones like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now we have 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. We did it! We cracked the final code!
Excellent work, Agent! You've mastered using base 10 blocks to identify and represent numbers up to 50, unlocking the first key. You're one step closer to unlocking the Great Castle of Numberland. Two more keys remain, and we'll need your skills next time more than ever to collect them. Stay sharp, Agent.
Wow, friend! You did a great job of using what you already know about base 10 blocks to identify and represent larger numbers. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time. Hey, hey.